Thank you very much. Give a hand for Matt, your MC here tonight. Yeah. Yeah, sure. Well, good evening, everybody. Hope you're having a happy New Year. Yeah, New Year's real big time of the year, huh? Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, New Year's not that big of a day for me. My favorite day of the year is Keith Richards' birthday. The guy lived another year, man. That's a testimony to partying, you know. For those of you who don't know, Keith is a guitar player for the Rolling Stones. Had his blood changed 3 times just so he can continue his heroin addiction. This guy's a party monster. I mean, he outlived Jim Fix the Runner, you know. Someone's doing something right here. I think he sleeps in formaldehyde. It's at 90 dips in. Keith, there's a nuclear war. 2 things are going to live, Keith and bugs, man. That's it. Like, where did everybody go? I saw a bright light. I thought we were on. Time is on my side. Yeah, we're watching Entertainment Tonight on Entertainment Tonight this week at the condo, you know. They came out and announced the world's wealthiest performer happens to be a rock star. Any idea who it is? Paul McCartney. Yeah, they announced Paul McCartney makes an estimated $10 million a month. Kind of puts our lives in perspective, doesn't it? It's a big world out there. I'm watching that with all the guys, and we're sitting there going, $10 million a month. God damn, God. This one guy goes, yeah, but taxes eat that up. All right, say they take $9 million a month away from Paul. You think this guy's scrambling for rent? Ringo, you've got to help me, baby. Landlord's knocking at me door. I think it'd be cool to be a rock star, man. It'd be Mick Jagger. Imagine being Mick, billionaire elf in the playground of the world. You know, done everything with everybody. You've been everywhere. I mean, what does it take to get Mick off? I've got an idea. I just had an idea. Let's buy a blimp. There's more. Buy a blimp and put our names in lights backwards and fly over a fucking lake. Boy, you're not jaded, are you, Mick? Only thing is, how do you spell Keith? K-E-E-F, Keith. Hey, Keith, how you spell your name, baby? Keith! What, are we on? Am I getting married, Walt? Keith, you just got new blood, man. Stay awake. I know Mick, but I keep getting Jim Morrison's blood. So, good evening. My name is Bill Hicks, 23 years old right now, going through my sexual prime. Boy, are my arms tired. Thanks for your compassion. Tell you, the scariest thing about being my age, man, I look just like my dad. I realized that over the holidays. I look more and more like my dad every day. That's scary to me. I'm afraid I'm going to wake up and start acting like my dad one day. I love my dad, you know, but he's a goober. He means well, he just doesn't pull it off. And you guys ever found yourselves sitting around the house, not really thinking, like this? I always want to be aware of my sock level. Bill, how come you never bring your friends over anymore? Because you look like a pretzel, Dad. So that was my New Year's resolution. I'm never going to act like that, man. I swear. The day I go outside, wait for the paper boy in my underwear. Fuck. Just blow me away, man. You are residue on the run at that point. I've seen my dad in a Bermuda jumpsuit. It's like a psychedelic farmer. Walk into McDonald's and go, "Excuse me, do you serve hamburgers here?" "Dad, could you wait in the car, please? You're embarrassing the entire family." Luckily, the guy behind the counter was acting like his dad. "Wait a minute, I'll check." Oh, this could take forever. Yeah, I went home for Christmas, you know. Boy, going home for Christmas, it's always good. Seeing the folks again. I realize after 5 minutes why you left in the first place. Oh, yeah, I hate this shit. Makes that one-bedroom apartment look better, doesn't it? When Mom and Dad aren't creeping around. Yeah. Boy, for Christmas. Old Spice, Dad. Hey, all right, man. Guess I'll just empty out this Halston. Come on, Dad, wake up, man. Yeah, I grew up in the Evel Knievel period, you know? Anyone grow up in that period? Isn't that great? Remember that? Building ramps out of plywood and bricks and jumping the dumbest guy in your group on a Schwinn bike. They'd lay him down there. "Don't worry, man. Are you sure you can do this?" "Just close your eyes, dude." Guy with the bike would get 10 blocks away and start pumping. 13th block, pull the muscle, he's out of breath. Coast over the ramp. "Sorry, dude." Thanks to plastic surgery, I can come up here tonight, though, and I've been lucky. Yeah, so when we were 12, we all wanted go-karts. Yeah, it was Evel Knievel. "Let's get go-karts, all my friends and I. We wanted go-karts, all my friends, for Christmas. They got go-karts. I'm 12 years old. I got a college dictionary. I swear to God, on a stand." Whoa. Boy, you could almost hear the other kids going, "Forget the go-karts, let's go over to Bill's house, look up words." Party. So all my friends are driving by the house. "Ah, this is great." I'm sitting there with my dictionary. Mom goes, "Bill, it's the fault that counts." "Oh, Mom, what were you thinking? God, damn. What train of thought led to this?" My dad goes, "Well, look, son, go-kart's in it." So is tightwad, Dad. "Hey, here's jerk." Yeah. See, I grew up in a neighborhood. I had friends, man, 14 years old. Parents gave them a hardship license and a Porsche. You want to have friends like that? What kind of hardship is this family undergoing, man? Can I get a piece of that? I tell it to my dad, and he's just, "Well, good for your friend, Bill. Hooray." I'll tell you, son, he's going to regret it one day. When? When the drill team's giving him head down? "Wish I never got this car. Wish I was at Hicks' house looking up words, man." "Well, Bill, when you get out of here and you get your own place to stay, you can do as you mighty well hoo-haw please. Now, as long as you're under this roof and you're a member of this family, you're gonna be miserable." I had to drive a big wheel to school my 12th year. No dates. Now I drive a Chevette. I'd rather have the big wheel. Anybody here drive a Chevette?
Yeah.
You do? You do? What year? 81. Still working? All right. They're good. They are good cars. Mine came with an optional blade so you can cut the lawn. Did you get that? Vouch for me on that. You turn the air conditioner on the Chevette while you're driving it. It's like hitting the car in the balls. The car's just, This goes down to 5 miles an hour. It's like the Flintstones in this fucking. You push the lighter in, the battery light comes on. I hope I'm not straining you. I hit a moth on the way up here. Did $400 damage. Moth's all right. Yeah. So we're driving up here, you know. See the sign on the freeway all the time. It says speed limit enforced by unmarked vehicles. Big deal, man. I'm speeding in an unmarked vehicle. They'll never know it's me. You ever see that sign, start wondering who it is looking around you, you know? Is it the old lady with the blue hair? Can't see over the dashboard? The guy with the mirrored sunglasses and the pistol? Finally, the guy pulled off the road. I sped up. Old lady pulled me over. I would have bet money on those odds. Yeah, I think I'm going to go berserk in a second here. Just for no apparent reason. Yeah, I like that voice. Yeah, good voice, Bill. I like to do for you now, Tom Waits for Color Track. Any Tom Waits fans here?
Yeah.
I love Waits, man. What a character.
This is a song I wrote when I lived in a dumpster.
Boy, hit us with it, Tom. I can relate. Tom Waits for Color Track.
My eyes are red, my clothes are stained, and my breath stinks. If you can see this, you're not nearly as wasted as I am.
So we're up here, we're in Indiana. Yeah, I was up, where was I? I was in Arkansas last week. It's good to be alive, folks. People in Arkansas think the Marlboro Man is a pussy, all right? Some serious folk down there. Arkansas, land of opportunity. It's true, there's nowhere to go but up if you live in Arkansas. But it's going to be a good year, man. Been dating a girl 7 years now. I think I'm finally going to pop the question. Why are we still seeing each other? God damn, I'm tired of looking at you. I can't deal with this chick anymore, man. Constantly distraught. Constantly calls me on the phone. I don't know who I am. Fuck, how did you know to call me? What are the odds of that? I'm thinking about jumping in front of a bus and you're not being very helpful. So I sent her a bus schedule. Hey, there's one every hour. Take your pick. Can I get on with my life, please? Yeah. Breakups are a lot of fun. Tell you who blows me away is Van Gogh, man. Ooh. Whoa, Vance. You know what he did when his girl left him? Cuts off his ear and sent it to her. God damn. That makes a dozen roses look like a booger. God.
God. Are you sure you love her, Vance? What?
I think Vince likes this chick. Man, I was going to go one up on Van Gogh when I broke up. I was going to cut off both my ears. Send a note telling her to call me, you know, anything. Glad I have friends. Yeah. Women confuse me, I admit it. Women are weird. Women are dichotomies. You call a woman a bitch in bed, she loves it. Same thing in a restaurant. Woo, boy. Shit hits the fan then. I'm just trying to please. Scary, man. When I had a girlfriend, other girls hit on me all the time. Weird phenomena. That, other girls hit on me. I figure what it is girls go, hey, she's one of us. She likes him. He must have something neat. Ah. When they leave you, it's, hey, she's one of us. She left him. He's a dick. I'm not going to waste my time finding out why. Shit. I'm having no luck, man. You think it's bad luck? Find out you're a diabetic going down on a girl wearing candy panties? She thought I was getting into it. I was having a seizure. It's funny when it's on the other foot. Tried dating this female inflatable doll for a while, get something going here. Worked out all right, except I had this inflatable guy looking for me. Hey, this guy was pissed, man. Took him out with a toothpick finally, fucking. Can only take so much. Don't mess with me, buddy. I did it. But went to college for a while. How many students we have here? Students? Where do you go? Went to where?
Seattle.
Seattle. All right. What'd you major in?
Finance.
You gonna pick up the tab tonight? Figure out that tip. What are you majoring in? Computers and math. It was a nice dry party. Yeah. I majored in philosophy. Ooh. Good move, Bill, you know. Hoping to open up my own little belief one day, you know. A lot you can do with a philosophy major, you know. I went to college 3 weeks, man. That was it. I could not wake up for that 8 o'clock class. You know that feeling? Shit. And I was going to night school. Fuck, man. This has got to be a hint, you know. Philosophy was good, though. I took philosophy, and what you get in philosophy is a bunch of jocks trying to make up credits. You know, they're trying to, they're not there to learn. I had an Eastern philosophy class, and the first day the instructor walked out and goes, God is consciousness, and we are all God trying to realize our full potential. Wow. Heavy duty class, man. This guy in the back row goes, yeah, we're going to need to know that. Is that going to be on the quiz? Yeah, I don't know. One of our textbooks was the New Living Bible. You familiar with this? The Bible in updated and modern English. This doesn't bug people at all to read. And Jesus walked on water. And Peter said, awesome. Boy, in Arkansas, I came across a lot of prejudice. Very interesting. Ran across this guy, told me adamantly that he hated Jewish people, man. Any Jewish people here tonight?
Yeah.
You Jewish? It's curious, man. The guy goes, I hate Jews. And I said, why, man? He goes, because they killed my God. He believed that, man. Shit. If I believed the Jews killed God, I'd worship the Jews, man. Shit, there's some badasses on that team, man. Yeah. I haven't seen God ever. I see Jews all the time. You figure it out. I think Israel should use that as their propaganda. You know? You got nuclear weapons? We killed the Lord. You can fuck with us if you want. Oh, shit, they got Keith Richards. We're goners. Last one with the flag. This is Marlon Perkins. Mutual of Omaha's Wild Kingdom. This week, we'll be going to the dark jungles of Alabama. Well, we'll watch in their natural habitat the dangerous and unpredictable Southern Christian. Jim, with his pure Anglo-Saxon ancestry, is able to get close enough to this suspicious breed to observe a pack of righteous Baptists stalk and kill their favorite prey, the wily American Negro. The Negro, though quick and rhythmic, is no match for this large gang of club-wielding Jesus lovers. All these preachers, man, want to get back to the good old days. That's their theme now. Let's get back to the good old days. Let's get back to the good old days. All right. Just when were the good old days, man? When were they? Am I, you know, 1973, the end of, it was a good old day. What happened in 73? Good drugs. Well, yeah. I don't think the preachers would agree with you on that point. Yeah, back when cocaine was 85% pure, yeah. Oh boy, I could do a Hail Mary sermon for hours on end. And I didn't get that cotton mouth from that speed either. You know what I'm talking about, too, don't you, my fellow brothers and sisters? I have an idea when the good old days were for these preachers. The good old days were when people were so confused. When people were so lost. When people were so ignorant. They'd follow anybody just because they had a strange speaking pattern. Amen, 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 amen. Comic struck by lightning. Yeah, he's talking about the PTL club. That's my personal favorite. Jim and Tammy Faye Baker. Oh, boy. Always crying about something. Please, brothers, we're going to tease Tammy Faye's hair all the way to heaven and climb up to God this year. But first of all, we need your paychecks. And your savings. Don't be shy for Jesus. You know, Tammy Faye, Jesus is coming back to us. Jesus is coming back to us. Could be true, man. In the Bible, Jesus hung out with whores and thieves. He might just go back to the PTO club. There's a whore and a thief if I ever saw one. Ah, fuck it. Be a good gig. Yeah, Mr. Reagan's trying to get prayer in public high schools. It's kind of interesting. You want prayer in high schools? Kind of weird, isn't it? I thought the whole point of the country was separation of church and state, right? Now, Reagan should know that. He was 10 when that went down, you know? No, I don't really care. I just wonder, it's not legal. It's not in it yet. I wonder what the kids are having to do, you know? Go in the stalls in the bathrooms. Dear God, dear Lord, dear Jesus. What's going on in here? Are y'all praying? I saw the Holy Ghost sneaking under that stall door. School. I'll tell you my school career in a nutshell, man. I remember in first grade, we were playing keep away from this girl with her pencil, right? Everyone's laughing, you know. Yeah, give me the pencil. Oh, cut it out. Oh, it was great, man. Pencil came to me. I throw it. Ah! Goes in this guy's eye, blinds him for life. What happened? Everyone in class is going, Jesus, Hicks, it's a game. What are you, a psycho, man? You ever have that a guy pull your chair out from under you're about to sit? You fall down? Do it to him, he breaks his back. In a wheelchair the rest of his life. That guy was in every one of my classes the next 5 years. You're real funny, Bill. Guy with one eye pushed him around. Don't know what to say to these guys. Well, you can park closer to the school now. May I be of some help? So that happened.
Return the sender.
Ooh. Yeah, you know, went home for Christmas. Always a cool thing to do. Go home and see my mom's cooking again. She cooks great, I think. I hear she cooks great. I've never eaten it. Possible to eat. My mom's there at the table with me, telling me about relatives and friends of hers that I don't know have cancer and tumors and leprosy. My mom's friends are falling apart. It's incredible. Trying to eat, and out of the blue, she'll go, Bill, 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 guess what? Your Aunt Jolina has died and gone to be with Jesus. That's kind of presumptuous. Oh, no, she's dead. Remember Aunt Jolina, don't you? She's the one with the flab under her arms that would slap you when she hugged you. Well, she was obese. The doctor told her she had to exercise or die. Who would have known she would have done both in the same breath? She bought a mini trampoline and set it up in the den. Took three jumps, realized she didn't turn off the ceiling fans. Like the blender with the top off. Bill, eat your cranberry sauce, honey. My folks wanted me to be a doctor. It didn't work out. But, my grades were so bad, man. My senior year, my mom actually said, Bill, you're going to end up picking up trash with the garbage man. Whoa. Pretty weird thing for her to say. First thing they taught me to do since I could walk was how to take out the garbage, you know? Suddenly it's an insult. Not many kids want to grow up to be garbage men, do they, huh? Policemen? Great. Fireman? Hey. Lawyer, doctor, super, garbage man, what's wrong with you, man? Reason is, there's no TV show called Marcus Welby Sanitation Engineer. That's it. One Adam Dump Truck, where is it? Little House on the Landfill, put it on TV. Kids will want to do it, you know. Failed a million jobs, man. Can't hold them. Always end up working for, what do they call, bosses? Guys that care about the job, they put a crimp in the workday, don't they? Always bugging me. Hicks, Hicks, how come you're not working? There's nothing to do, man. Well, pretend like you're working. Why don't you pretend that I'm working? Pretend I'm mopping. Knock yourself out, man. I'll pretend they're buying shit. Let's close up, Jack. Come on. You get this bill taken care of yet? Oh, great. Tipping the comedian. Long time no see. Thank you, Indiana. Oh, boy. That's going to come in handy. Oh, I will take credit cards. Holy cow. God damn it. I'll take your fine money, bourgeois bastards. Don't need your fine money. Oops, thought I was demon comic for a second. Worked for a while at a lady's shoe store. That was a good gig, man. It was. Women would come in wearing dresses to try on shoes, you know. Y'all do that on purpose? Just naive to how lecherous men can be, you know. I'm sitting there helping them on with their shoes. They're going, ah, oh, how does it look? Well, that looks great. It's you. It's kind of tight. I could stretch it out for you. So after I got fired from that job, so Mr. Reagan got reelected. Thank God. You're a big Reagan fan, huh? Yeah. See, I'm draftable. He doesn't really thrill me that much. I'm not really. When Carter was in office, I had to register for the draft. When Reagan got elected, I got a gun in the mail. Okay. Came with a Spanish to English dictionary, and I think something's up. But not that I don't want to join the army. The army, we do more before 9 a.m. than most people do in a whole day. That's supposed to get me to join. I go to bed at 8. Wake up at 9, take a shower with a bunch of bald guys. Then get shot at. Hey, there's a life option I fucking overlooked. Reagan came out the other day, announced his plan to curb world hunger. You see that? He's going to drop Dexatrim from helicopters over Ethiopia. Yeah, boy, he's got a lot of heart.
No, we're not hungry no more.
Great, we got a bunch of hyper-Ethiopians down there.
Have them build a pyramid.
Wrong culture, Ronnie. Good try, though. I don't know, my political stance, I got a bumper sticker on my car that says Hinckley for Reagan. But, Demon comic strikes. What can we talk about, folks? Great drug trial going on not long ago. Baseball player for Atlanta Braves got caught with 0.5 gram of cocaine in his wallet. You know who I'm talking about? Pascual Perez, that's right. 0.5 gram of coke, found guilty. Sentence was he could not play baseball for 1.5 months. Yeah, throw the book at the guy. Jesus, man. If I'm ever caught with cocaine, I'm going to plead guilty. Say, Your Honor, I won't touch a bat and a ball. Shit, make it a year. I won't even watch the World Series. Another great trial going on is the Henry Lee Lucas trial. You following this, anybody? Not exactly a fun topic to think about. Oh, boy. They're taking that trial around Henry Lee and his partner O'Toole to every city where a body was found that they killed. It's like a tour. You know. They're here. You know, big parade down Main Street. You know. Floats, missing arms and legs. I didn't kill the people. They did, okay? You know the story behind these guys, what they did? They would kill their victims. Then they would rape them. And oh, the night's still young. They would eat them. Oh. Swear to God. Henry Lee's response to that was, wait a minute, we didn't eat them. Oh, we killed them then raped them, but shit. We're not weird. Boy, those guys got nailed. They got nailed bad, man. They can't play baseball for 5 years. You know what's scary about mass murder is not how many people are killed, not even how they're killed. It's who they kill. That's what's frightening. Don't kill young girls. That ruins my odds. You're going to piss people off doing that. Kill the cast of the Love Boat. Blow Captain Steubing's head off. I could care less. Rape Gopher. I don't care. Kill people that won't turn right on red. Fuck them. Drag them out of their car. You can make a right on red, you fucking asshole. Maybe your next lifetime you'll remember that. Some people need to die. And I will put myself in a position to tell you who. Ah, man. No, I'm kidding. mob here. There's psychos out there, man. I'm driving around. I see hitchhikers all over the road. They expect to be picked up. Hitchhikers. They do? Really? Really? Henry Lee was a hitchhiker. Who picks up hitchhikers? No. They have a lot of bad press, man. Not about to pick up someone sitting by the side of the road with a Glad bag and an axe, you know? Holding up a sign that says, hell. Sorry, dude, I'm going north. Been to a horror movie lately? See the people that go to these things? Scarier than the goddamn movies, man. And you can hear stuff in the horror movie audience now, like, I remember when I cut off a head. Am I in your way? I will crouch for that guy. Ooh, 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 ooh. Feel too good. I feel too good. Stop it. But I like ants. Anyone have an ant farm when they were younger? Yeah. They great? Ants are my favorite animal, bar none, man. Love. I had an ant farm. Had to get rid of it because of the noise, but yeah, they'd sing in the fields. It was pretty weird. Old Man River, weirdest out here picking up crumbs. I think ants are amazing, man. You ever look at an anthill from overhead? Looks like a city at rush hour. Doesn't it? Trails of ants coming in and going out and coming in. For all we know, those ants are going, look at the traffic. It's a blade of grass, it's green, goddammit, go! This could be happening. Guys hate cats, man. I've been watching this. Guys hate cats. Very general rule, but they hate cats. And I figured out why. And I figured this out on acid. I'm not making it up, all right? Guys hate cats because they associate subconsciously cats with women because women are like cats and men are like dogs. It's a microcosm of the yin and yang energies in the animal kingdom. And women are just like cats. They're beautiful, independent, and deep down don't really need guys. This tends to piss guys off. No one owns a cat. You're the host for the cat. Party's good, they stick. You're late with the food, fuck you, baby. Things to do, people to see, all right? Over the fence, man. Remember what that dog thinks when that cat goes over the fence, huh? God damn, I wish I could do that. All I can do is dig a hole. Cats just flying about. What do you think's smarter, cats or dogs? Women say cats, men say dogs. See that? Figure it this way. Dogs chase balls, they chase sticks, they shake, they roll over, they speak, protect property, guide the blind. Cats do nothing. They get fed the same amount. Now, someone's got an angle on life here, and I think it's little kitty shitting on my stereo right now. I have a cat and a dog, and I can attest to you that cat does nothing all day long because I don't do anything and I watch it, all right? Man, he lays around all day long. Gets up, eats, goes to the bathroom, and goes back. Poor little kitty had to eat today. I bet you're tuckered out. Feed it as much as my dog, love it as much as my dog. My dog doesn't figure this shit out, man. Makes a fool out of himself on cue. Roll, speak, shake, go, rah. Thinks it's his job to protect my apartment. Anyone walks by has a coronary arrest, man. Get away, spill shit, get away. Get away, spill shit, get away. Cats go, man, it's all insured. Listen, folks, my time is up. Thank you very much. You have been fantastic. Thank you.